These girls came to us from Ohio. That's a long haul. And they're driving back home after this, and then they're coming back in 3 days for another conference, bless their hearts. But this is their first time here. I want you all to make them welcome. Ezekiel's Call. How about it, folks? Make them welcome to the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee.
There's a lot of people talking about people, looking down on everybody, acting like they're sitting on a steeple, keeping all their own faults locked up in a big vault, forgetting that God don't need a combination to see it all. Raise your hand if you ain't ever done nothing wrong. That's what I thought. Rocks are heavy, they hurt people you love. It's so easy reaching down and picking them up, but I ain't gonna throw no stones at nobody. Don't wanna get hit by a ricochet. Ain't got no room for no rocks in my pocket anyway. He just sat there drawing on the ground beside her. She was all red-handed, and man, they all couldn't wait to stone her. Now I'm just paraphrasing, but Jesus said, wait a minute. Step right up and be the first to throw if you ain't done some sinning. One by one, they all dropped their stones and went home. Rocks are heavy, they hurt people you love, and it's so easy reaching out and picking them up, but I ain't gonna throw no stones at nobody. Don't wanna get hit by a ricochet. Ain't got no room for no rocks in my pocket anyway. Sweet, sweet cornerstone was meant to be a place to hide and not something we throw.
You know, we're so quick to look at other people's sin and throw rocks, but we're not so quick to look at our own.
No, I ain't gonna throw no stones at nobody.
About Naaman.
Naaman the leper went down into the Jordan 7 times, and he came up shouting, oh Lord, I see my change. Naaman the leper went down into the Jordan 7 times, and he came up shouting, oh Lord, see my change. Now if you don't know what leper is, I want you to lend an ear. Why don't you open up the pages of your mind, and I'll paint you a picture there. See, there were sores on Naaman's body, spreading from limb to limb. Seen many a doctor, but there was no hope for him. Till one day, hey, little servant girl said, Master,
Master,
good news. I know somebody who knows somebody who knows what to do for you.
So she sent him on to a prophet. He couldn't believe his ears when the prophet told him to dip in the water of the mighty river down there. He said, you gotta go down into Jordan seven times and you'll come up shouting, oh Lord, I see my change. He said to go down into Jordan seven times and you'll come up shouting, oh Lord, see my change. So he went on down in the water one time and then again. Homeland where the waters ran crystal clear. He wondered why that prophet had to bring him way down here. But he went on down for the fourth time and he started to go back home when a voice called out to him, Naaman, hold on, there's no power in that water, Naaman, not in that muddy stream. See, power comes from doing what God said. And he said to go down into Jordan seven times and you'll come up shouting, oh Lord, see my change. So he went on down for the fifth time, body still covered with sores. And it seemed like that old muddy water made the pain more. Six times in the Jordan, six times so strange. Six times he looked at himself and six times no change. Well, I know he must have thought somehow way back in his mind. He thought he'd be freed from the dread disease without dipping seven times. Well, I know.
To say that a wandering soul
Ezekiel's Call. Thanks for being with us tonight, ladies.
Thanks for having us.
So you all come from us from, you all came to us from Ohio, right?
Yes.
That's a chunk of time. How far away?
We are about 8 hours.
Yeah, so you were on the road yesterday in Georgia?
Yes.
Yeah. And so you decided to stop back by because you know Landry, is that right?
I mean, we don't like to tell people that.
Yeah.
But
how
yeah.
do you guys, how do you know each other? Just through gospel music?
Yep.
Yeah. So, and if you can't tell, they're sisters. But I was like, are they twins? Who do you think's oldest? She.
Someone
pointed
like this.
That way. You're right. You're the oldest, right?
Yes.
Well, introduce yourselves for me.
My name is Jennifer, and I am actually 5 years older than my baby sister, Jamie. We have one sister in between us as well.
Okay, does she sing with you ever?
She doesn't sing with us, but we grew up singing with my dad's group, mm-hmm. and she still sings with them.
Okay, so that's really kind of how you got introduced into it, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah? Well, I know, like, the first song you sang, I think that was, did Sonia Isaacs write that, I think?
Yes.
So, do you like the Isaacs?
Yeah.
Who were some of them. The groups that you listen to or that you enjoy?
Well, we definitely grew up on the Isaacs. Remember going to me and Mom Papaw's house with their little cassettes of the Isaacs.
Yeah.
So we definitely grew up on the Isaacs. But some people we look up to today, the Tallies, the Hoppers, other groups like that.
Yeah, so you all are based out of Ohio. Do you get down south much?
A few times a year.
Yeah?
Yeah. Not as much as we'd like, but yes.
So, and how long has the group been together with you two?
Ezekiel's Call started in 2012.
Yeah, so you've been doing it a few years, and you actually work too.
We do, yes.
Yes, so you're both in insurance?
Yes.
Do you work in the same office?
Competing companies, actually.
Wow, yeah. Competing companies. That's funny that you guys are doing that. Do you live together too?
We are roommates, yes.
Oh, do you guys ever fight?
Rarely.
Really?
Yeah, we get along.
So you're on the
well.
Road and, you know, so is she the big talker more?
She really is.
Yeah.
On the road, in the hotel.
And she's
on
the baby.
Stage. Yes. I am the baby.
Who
yes.
gets to pick where you go eat?
It's always one of those, you pick. No, you pick.
What do you
know.
Want? I don't care.
We're yes. both women. I
hate that. I'm like, okay, we're going to Cracker Barrel. And then they're like, well, I don't want to go there. Too bad. That's where you're going. You should have said something.
Yes.
That's what I always say when, you know, when we're driving. So are you all in Ohio with like Skyline Chili? Is that close to you or no?
We have one close to us.
Yeah,
I've
I
never
like
been
it.
There though.
You're kidding.
No.
It's like an Ohio thing to do.
It is. Yeah. It's based out of Cincinnati, which
right.
is on the opposite end of Ohio.
Okay.
We're way up by the lake.
Yeah. So if folks want to get information about you, I know you brought some CDs here. Did you set them up down there
yes,
somewhere?
Yes, we did.
So how many albums do you have?
We only have one.
Okay. How mm-hmm. much are they?
They're $15.
$15. So they have one album out, guys. If you want to purchase one after the show, they'll be down there. But if folks are listening, want to get your music or maybe get a hold of you all for a booking or something, how does that happen?
So if you want to call, you can call 615-379-8010.
Okay.
And we also have everything on our website as well as contact information, which is www.ezekielscallministries.com.
One last thing, where did the name come from?
So a few years back, our pastor posed a question to us, and he said, since when did Christians start believing that God was going to send us into safe places to do easy things? And that really settled in our heart, and I think that's Ezekiel's story as well. God sent him into dangerous places to do unsafe things, and we relate to that a lot.
Yeah, so to be challenged and go and do that, okay. Girls, thank you for coming. Folks, let's make them welcome as they come. One more time, Ezekiel's Call.
Thank you.
Well, Lazarus had been sick for a long, long time. Mary and Martha stopped and questioned why. They both sent for Jesus, but before he arrived, Lazarus had already died. 4 days later, Jesus had come to them. Martha said, if you'd have been here, then you could have saved him. Then they went to the tomb, and Jesus did cry, Lazarus, come forth, and he came walking out alive. He came out of the grave, all once was dead, but he's alive. Now I must say, he came out of the grave and gave God the praise. Yes, on resurrection day, he came out of the grave. Hanging on a cross on crucifixion day, the crowd scorned and mocked his holy name. His mother at his feet bound her head and cried for her precious baby boy had give up his life. 3 days later, women came to the tomb. They were wrapped up in their sadness. They were drowning in their gloom. But as they arrived, for to their surprise, an angel said, "Do not fear, King Jesus is alive." He came out of the grave on resurrection day. He had fulfilled his duty to come and to say. He came out and took the victory, and Satan was done. He had to admit right there, Jesus had won. He came out of the grave on resurrection day. He had fulfilled his duty to come and to say. He came out and took the victory, and Satan was
Ezekiel's call, folks, right here on the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee. Thank you, ladies, for coming. Okay, guys, we're going to keep it going with more gospel music. Let's welcome Westward Road to the Smoky Mountain Gospel Jubilee. How about it?
answer when there is no other way, Jesus.
radio single called Keep Holding On. I'm going to keep holding on till it comes back.
Keep holding on, he's coming soon. Could be today, tomorrow morning, night or noon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep holding on, he's coming soon. Keep holding on, he's coming soon.
Sure, when the trumpet sounds, I'll be ready for my ride to glory land.
Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon. Could be today, tomorrow morning, night or noon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon. Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon.
Sometimes I get down in the dumps, discouraged, full of fear. I begin to fret, but then I call on the name of Jesus. I know he's coming soon to save the day.
Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon. Could be today, tomorrow morning, night or noon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon. Keep a holding on, he's a coming soon.
All the way to the end, it told that every knee is gonna bow,
every tongue will confess that he is Lord. Hallelujah, glory, glory, worthy is the Lamb. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Could be today, tomorrow morning, night or noon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Holding on, he's coming soon. Could be today, tomorrow morning, night or noon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Don't know the hour, but I know it won't be long. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon. Keep a holding on, he's coming soon.
You guys are going to know this one. We want you to sing along with us, okay? I heard an old, old story of a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary, and he saved a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and he bought me with his blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood.
Tell us about it.
Oh, I heard about heaven. He has built for me in glory. And I've heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea. And I found the angels singing, and that old redemption story. And some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory.
Smith Madison Ogle Properties has been serving the people of Sevier County for over 80 years, making them one of the area's leading forces in commercial and residential properties. Whether you're looking for an apartment, a home, or a business venture, Smith Madison Ogle has over 400 locations. To make an appointment on how we can serve you better, call 865-428-5161 or log on to smoproperty.com.
So I think the thing that really sets us apart is that we are a family-run business. The Ogle family has been here since day one of Sevier County, and they're bringing their furniture to the public. We're trying to make a better experience for people. We're giving you the option of custom ordering and still having the option of taking something with you that we have in stock. My salespeople are very knowledgeable. They will ask you questions and tailor the exact room perfect for you. We also have a kiosk, an online catalog, if you will, that will help you navigate through all the furniture.
Since 1978, the folks at the Ogle Repair Company have been keeping folks cool, warm, and safe in their home and businesses in East Tennessee. From fixing heat pumps, electronic air cleaners, ice machines, refrigeration, gas furnaces, coolers, freezers, we do it all. Sales, service, installation, and servicing. Call 865-453-5654 for Ogle Repair Company. You can also visit us online at www.oglerepair.com.